Today we're going to talk about how to level up weapons a little bit faster. There's always new methods coming out. Obviously, if you have the full versions of the game, there's great ways to level up, whether it's face-off, 6v6, Nuketown, 12v12, whatever. When it comes to Cold War, if you want to go shipment on multiplayer on Modern Warfare, those are great ways to go. But there are a lot of people, and I'm sure the majority of you out there, that do not own those versions of the game. So you're kind of stuck with these options, which is scopes and scatter guns, Rebirth, Rebirth Resurgence Quads, Payload, Clash, Battle Royale, and Iron Trials. And one thing that's going to limit you here is it really comes down to your individual skill level. So we're going to talk about what makes one better than the other, and we'll talk about various strats so you can maximize this XP and gain several levels regardless of your individual skill level. Enjoy the video. Hit the like button. If you're brand new and want to find your way back, double check. Make sure you are subscribed with notifications on. So as you can see, I've already max leveled the Vanguard weapons. Hopefully all that progress will carry over. But regardless of that, one general thing that I want to point out when it comes to loadouts, especially with a lot of the methods that we're going to talk about, is that for the second perk or perk two, you're going to want to equip Point Man. If you're playing in a full team, everyone should be equipping Point Man, because although the description kind of says what it does, it doesn't cover all the details here. So it says Warzone only, all members of your team earn more money from completed missions. No effect in Warzone Rumble. In case you guys didn't know, outside of Plunder, any contract you do makes it so the next contract is worth more. Usually it's by 10% increments or 20% increments. So the next one will be worth 120, then 140, then 160, then 180, then 200%. And that goes for money, XP, and weapon XP. So if you use this, it automatically is going to start you at, like, as if you've already done two or three contracts. If everyone on your team has this, it's like you've already done eight contracts. So you skip the line and you start at like 200, 300%. Versus going 100, 120, 140, you skip a significant part of that. So you'll be able to get way more XP because of the way the multiplier works. So now that we've covered that portion, it's incredibly important to understand if you're going to be comfortable with a weapon. If I'm going to be using a meta weapon, I can probably do some of the things that are based off kills. If there's going to be a weapon that maybe it's going to be a little bit harder, standard melee weapon, maybe the crossbow, maybe a sniper rifle, if you're not really good at sniping, then the kill-based ones aren't really all going to be that easy to do. I can't say, oh, well, just do this, drop 60 kills, land at Storage Town and plunder and just rack up the kills. Super easy, best method. Well, that doesn't really work for somebody who's only going to struggle to maybe get 5 kills, 6 kills using a different type of weapon. So we'll go ahead and go through the different various ones. Plunder, pretty straightforward. There's two methods. There's the low skill option, which is to do the contracts. With the full team, you can go ahead and get the helicopters. You can do the supply runs. You can do this solo, but it can be a little bit inconsistent. If you do not get a heli right off the bat, if there's other people doing them, it'll be kind of contested. People will try to launcher you out of the sky. Whatever it is, there is some inconsistency with it. But if you're in a full team, it increases the likelihood that you'll be able to do more of them. And that one's usually pretty low skill because you don't have to get in a gunfight. You just fly from one supply run to another. The other strategy is to fight for the train right off the bat. Pretty standard. And then you just go ahead and do the recon. Everyone jump on it because it completes it faster. Wait 45 seconds, it'll respawn in. And you do this for the entire match. You should be able to get a decent amount of them. If you've kind of fought people off, you should be relatively uncontested for the most part, because a lot of people have gone and done their own thing, or they'll leave the match. Pretty straightforward. High skill one, go for a bunch of kills in Storage Town. That's about as easy as it gets. But depending on what your weapon, that could be really tricky to do and to go for a lot of kills. So the other way is to do the normal battle royale. And this is to go to the train and do the train strat. Go ahead, loot up. There's usually gold boxes. Get a loadout ASAP. Everyone get the loadout right away with Point Man, and that multiplier is going to be shooting up. And you'll just do the exact same thing. You'll see how many contracts you can do by the time the zone actually starts collapsing. So it really is zone dependent. You will be pushed out. If you die, you got to worry about regaining. If you get shot at, it will be contested. So you kind of end up with some issues with that. So it can be a little bit harder. And then on Rebirth, Rebirth contracts are incredibly easy to do, especially if the lobby starts to die off pretty quickly. Then you just go ahead and do contracts since they're so close together. Instead of you having to run like 300 meters or like 500 meters for a supply run, they're like 150 meters. A lot of times the zone's smaller, you can kind of just bounce those contracts back and forth where you grab one, somebody's already on the buy station, you grab another one, it does it again. Just as long as your weapon is in your hand, you'll get those weapon XP multipliers from all of those contracts. Obviously, if you have XP tokens, this is going to make it even go even further. I didn't really mention that in the general, but that's pretty important. Then it comes to whether or not Clash is good or Payload. And this is where I think a lot of people kind of get into debates. I was kind of going back and forth. I played both modes seriously to try and see which mode was going to be more effective. And hands down, Clash is the better way to go, in my opinion, just because it's easier, low effort, super straightforward. The only RNG is which part of the map you end up on, because some are a little bit better than others, but we'll talk about that. And then Payload, you just go for kills, stay next to the vehicle, do the objective. But if you're playing with a gun that's really hard to get a lot of kills, you may struggle on that one. So I wouldn't necessarily recommend Payload unless it's just a easy meta gun, super easy to level, but odds are you already have those leveled. So when it comes to Clash, I did this solo, and I did this with random fill. Random fill led to more consistency, because what happens when you grab a contract in this mode, they're all bounties. The multiplier goes up by more than just one when they're completed. But if you do it solo and you die, you lose out on the contract. But if you're in a team, you die, you could respawn, the contract still stays alive. And once that person dies, whoever kills them, because you're all a part of the same team, regardless of your squad, you're going to get credit for it. Like as if you completed it. It's not like it poached. So I think they'll eventually switch this so it's not that way. But right now it works so that if somebody dies, you get poached. Boom, you grab the next one. They get poached because people die pretty quickly in this mode. Grab another one. Poached. 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 And you can do like 12, 15 of them. Keeping in mind that it really depends on the map. You grab what you can. Halfway through the match, it's 7.5 minutes. They restock. And then you go ahead and grab them again. And odds are these will be a little contested, like just trying to land on them, but people kind of just realize, hey, you know what? There's not enough, and they'll probably leave the match, and then you'll be able to get the rest of them. So that's the way I would go. As you can see, I was getting a ton of XP, like a stupid, ridiculous amount. And this thing was going up levels, even on the higher levels, it was going up fast. Not like from 1 to 11. It was like from 43 to like 62. Which is crazy levels. So hopefully that helps you out, that all you got to do is just go grab a contract, stay alive. If you're in a random quad, more power to it. Hopefully everyone on your team is running the point man perk, and that'll make it easier for you. So try it out for yourself. Let me know how it goes. If you enjoyed the video, learned something new, please do me a favor, hit the like button. If you're brand new, want to find your way back, double check, make sure you are subscribed with notifications on. Thank you for watching. As always, have a great day.